And welcome back to Norway. We are in Florida. I can remember approximately Lima under Augustine's winters for January. Still having issues with it. I actually removed all the FTX Norway files from I can remember approximately Lima and try to put them in the wrong folder, but I don't know. Still having issues. Still getting double sets of buildings. So it's hard to comment on how good it is or not. I think probably it's my fault. Probably I didn't really read the instructions that much. Which is stupid. But I have a long list of flights to to do here, and I'm not gonna restart 100 times to get it working correctly. Even though probably I should have. So I'm sorry. I should have paid more attention when I initially installed it. Anyways, today we are going from Førde to Førde Bringeland, which is also serves the same sort of town, but it's in the mountains away. And from there on, I think we're going to go on down to Sogndal. Augustine has actually done all three things, but considering since I sort of couldn't get this first one to install properly, I'm going to run with the Airports of Norway versions of those airports. For now, maybe that's my issue, that I didn't move the Airports in Norway version of this one, but I thought that there wasn't one. Anyway, it's a little bit too late for me to fix it. What we're going to do is we're going to try and tune into this ADF on 245 and fly direct to that one. Not that I really remember how to do that in this plane, but I think we'll find it. 3, 4, 5. Let's see. Okay, come on. How do we do this? 3, 4, 5. Okay. That's basically it. Let's also get the weather while we're at it, and then here's the comm radio. Okay, it's actually tuned in already.
Echo November Foxtrot Lima Airport information Delta 1650 Zulu weather wind 078 at 4 visibility 10 sky condition few clouds at 500 temperature 3 dew point 2 QNH 1012 advise on initial contact you have information Delta Echo November Foxtrot Lima Airport information Delta 1650 Zulu weather wind 078 at 4 visibility 10 sky condition few clouds at 500 temperature 3 dew point 2 QNH 1012 advise on initial contact you have information Delta Echo November Foxtrot Lima Airport information Delta 1650 Zulu weather wind 078 at 4 visibility 10 sky condition few clouds at 500 temperature 3 dew point 2 QNH 1012 advise on initial contact.
Yeah, I'm not so good at knowing where everything is in this plane, unfortunately, but here we go. We're gonna take off heading east, basically. Runway 7 here. That wind's coming in from almost directly. Directly, we've taken up almost directly into the wind. Even though it's clearly some messed up insulation, I think this airport looks kind of promising. I like the runway textures, and I like the sheds and stuff that I see here. And nice break from the usual stuff that you see from our bikes, so it's nice to break it up a little bit. We're flying Carenados Cessna Caravan EX today. I really don't know how to use the G1000 very well, so always a little confused. I think the thing is I always wonder whether or not it's worth it to sort of put the time in to learn it properly. I just feel like it doesn't seem like that capable of a unit in FSX. So but who knows? It's I could totally be wrong here. Yeah, I wonder.
topo.
I like how the performance seems to be okay though. The G1000, it used to be terrible back in FSX, I remember. I don't know if that's Carenados' fault or FSX's fault or whatever, but for me it just seems a lot more usable now.
Echo, November, Foxtrot, Lima, traffic. Cessna, taking off, runway 7, east departure. Echo, November, Foxtrot, Lima.
Take off trim. Increase the condition of the prop. It's a terribly difficult plane to taxi this. I feel like it just wants to go straight away. So I got double windsock action here, everything. Everything. I don't know how to put this up. Once again, I don't know how to do something in this plane. Let's see, DME ADF. Oh, I got a little yellow thing there. A little. Oh, that's okay. It's probably, maybe it is this pink line. No, the pink line is the GPS. Anyways, whatever. Things I don't know in flight sim are many. Because it's going fast though. We got good climb right here already. Ferry. I'm seeing a lot of bugs recently, and talked about it on some of my other streams that I've made recently that I'm really, really starting to get into, not into, I'm just curious about. X-Plane looks great. X-Plane 11 looks really, really good, and it's very interesting. Package for clouds using ASCA as the weather injector, ASCA and Active Sky 16. Talked before about how much I love Active Sky 16. I think it's a fantastic program. Not been much of a fan of ASCA, but I think with the MTEX package, it's starting to make sense to me because they've actually injected textures into ASCA that I enjoy, that I think look. Nice enough, soft, and cloudy. Yeah. So Bringeland is actually a really interesting approach. It's kind of between two mountains on a mountain. See if we can find some charge for this. That's what I want to do. Yeah. Okay, not available.
Terrain.
Wait.
Terrain. 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 Terrain.
Wow. This is what you don't want to happen. Land here today. Not if this weather does not improve significantly. Or I can find some charts. I do think they actually have an instrument approach. Okay, let's do the localizer runway 7. It's kind of what we want. Okay, finally we found what we needed. Very bad planning on my part. I accept all 110.7. And the direction is 073.
Echo November Sierra Delta traffic. Waiter 152 is 11 miles west inbound. Visual, runway 9. Echo November Sierra Delta.
A lot of scrolling you need to do in this Carenado aircraft. I don't know, just don't like them. Just don't like them, guys. I keep flying them, but I don't like them. Okay, so let's try and backtrack. Let's turn around, go back, and let's see if we can't capture that localizer. If I can do this with this plane, then I'm not comfortable with the plane, and I'm not comfortable with the airport or the approach. I'll be really impressed with myself. It'll be fully manual, more or less, because I don't know how to fly this plane properly. I find it very sensitive. Look, I just tried to just throw a little bit, and it just down. Let's see if we can zoom in here. So, where do we want to catch this? We want to catch it about 10 miles out. Okay, so the DME. Confused about everything. What was the 110.7? I can put it in nav 2 box just for the hell of it. That's pretty stupid. And the 073. Here it is, and I'm just totally blind. So this is the distance. So at 10.5, we want to be at 5,000 feet, which is what we're at. Perfect. And then 10.5, when we have 5, we want to proceed at a descent rate of about 700 feet. Okay, I think what we'll do is we'll actually, just to make life a little easier for ourselves, we will turn on the autopilot.
Echo November Sierra Delta traffic. Waiter 152 is 1 mile west inbound. Visual, runway 9. Echo November Sierra Delta. Delta, traffic. Waiter 152 is flying a missed approach. Echo November Sierra Delta.
I will do that, so put it into heading mode. Directly south to try and intercept this guy. Then we'll arm the nav, which is our localizer, and once we get to once we get to 10.5 miles, we'll try and slow this plane down to about 100 knots, and we'll do a descent of 640. I'll actually start slowing it down now. It's gonna be a lot happening here. Not sure if it's nav or approach that I'm supposed to be arming here, but I'm arming the approach. Let's see if that works. Very difficult. Look at this weather, I can't see anything. Getting kind of close to the intercepting the localizer, should we? Yeah, we certainly have it. That's something. I just turn on the audible there to sort of listen to if we have contact with the localizer. Right, 10.5 miles, 120, that's 770. Okay, so minus 800. For me. What's the minimums here? The minimums are 1930. Okay, so that's the altitude to 1930. Okay, 1900, that will be due. goes. Fast. I do think we're a little above glide slope. Yeah, okay, then we should pay attention to the vocalizer. Miles out, we should be on 2,000 feet. We're on 2,900 feet too high. Well, we're out of the clouds. Just. Soup there, huh? I didn't see the airport either. 2,200 feet, 2,100 feet. We're coming up on our minimums here.
Echo November Sierra Delta traffic. Waiter 152 is 11 miles west inbound. Visual, runway 9. Echo November Sierra Delta.
I'm supposed to cancel. I will cancel.
Terrain.
Terrain. Not perfectly. It's pretty bad.
Terrain.
Actually.
Terrain. Terrain.
So, that, I think it's fair to say that we're not going to be landing there. We are going to go on to Sogndal. ENSG, that's what it was. Challenge, pick a plane you don't know, fly somewhere where you don't know, and fly it in some really shitty weather like this, and try and put you don't know with an instrument panel you don't know. Try it. That basically, the more you don't know, the worse it's gonna get, right? This has been pretty awful. I think I'm gonna turn on the autopilot and to terrain, but we're not that close to the terrain.
Echo November Sierra Delta traffic. Waiter 152 flying the missed approach. Echo November Sierra Delta.
Okay, so let's see if we can find the ENSG charts. And I think they have an ILS out there, which I think we need today. Sogndal. And yes, they do. They have an ILS on runway 24, which is what we're definitely gonna do today. Okay, so it's 114.2. Direction 234. I know that's against the wind, but that is what it's going to be today. Almost alone fuel.
Echo
have to say, I don't like Carenado planes. They're way too twitchy. I think they don't behave how I believe they should behave in real life. I don't know, I've never flown a caravan in real life. Like, I've been in one, but I've never flown one. But they seem so twitchy, man. Like, this whole plane seems so twitchy, and I don't know what that is. It can't possibly be meant to be like this. I just don't buy it. Anyway, so this one we have we'll intercept 6,300 feet. Wow. And the minimums is 2,500 feet. And it's a steep approach at 4 degrees. And I know the airport elevation is quite high. Yeah, 1600 feet. It's on the top of a mountain, literally. Okay. We'll actually head out once we get a little further south here. We'll just go straight on a heading of 09, go straight east, I think. And then we'll go straight south and intercept the ILS directly instead of flying over the airport. I guess we could do that though. So what we're seeing out here is the Sogndal Fjord, which is the longest fjord in Norway. Our next best option is Bergen, which is all the way out the fjord again. And my intended next stop is flight. Just say, I think the ENFL package is really good. I like these clouds. I installed the low-res version of the clouds actually. And I think that was pretty good. Window, what it's in the fog, but I think it's because of like between two layers or something. So let's see here. Basically, so as you can see, we're basically, it wants us to sort of intercept north of this little nook here. Yeah, let's do it. Put it into heading mode. And let's put the CDI into have mode. see if we can get it right now. So it's doot doot doot. Long, 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 doot. I'm confused again. I'm confused as what is the actual ILS frequency here? Because it's a VOR. That's a localizer. Where is the glide slope, yo? I guess it must be this one, 108.100. But that's a localizer, not an ILS. I'm guessing it's this, but it's kind of the localizer that's saying 101.1, and the direction of course is 234. Still, So we're gonna have to do this manually again. So we're doing an approach of about 850, doing about 120 knots. That's a theme of 10-2. There's no glide slope on either of these two. So I think I'll go with the localizer because that is at least more accurate. And Mine 4009. So at 4 miles, we should be at 3005. Here were 2005. Kind of a graphical anomaly makes it a little bit easier to see this. autopilot, and we're gonna go into land. We are too high. So we can maybe salvage it. Thrust on and full brakes and well, we made it down. It wasn't pretty, but we made it down. Had a little bit of fuel left. Not much, but some. That was a really challenging weather, I have to say, and a couple of really, really difficult approaches. I think if I had a better plane and some time to study it, and if I was a bit more prepared as to what I was going to face, this may have gone better. I think Bringeland was obviously not going to happen today in this weather. It's just impossible, but Sogndal could have happened, made happen better. Anyway, this is, I think it's airport, no, FTX Norway's rendition of Sogndal. Nothing too amazing, but it is what it is. Which is kind of what you can say about the whole flight too. Anyways, thanks for watching. This is pretty bad. See if I can't get us a better flight happening next time around. But thanks for watching nonetheless. It was fun to have you along. It's crazy ride. Okay, bye bye.